We're in Hyde County at the site of the Blackland Farm Managers Tour, August the 2nd, 2016. We're looking at our maximum yield test, tests that's supported by the North Carolina soybean producers with their checkoff funds, tests where we're trying to do as much as we can to jack yields up and then sequentially subtract treatments out as a way to measure what's that treatment contributing to yield. We're going to intentionally get to rows 20 inches or under. We happen to be in 15-inch rows here. But we've got quite a bit of data from quite a few years that says that row widths 20 inches or under will yield higher than anything wider than 20. Here we've got 30-inch rows instead of 15. Two things showing up. One, we're not lapping the middles. We got a little bare ground in between. So we got sunlight that's falling on bare ground and being wasted. We're not capturing it by leaves. And they're a little shorter. Right here in front, they're not quite 3 feet tall. We get a little farther back in the plot, they are. Going from 15-inch rows to 30-inch rows, that was about a 7-bushel difference too. And that we kind of expected, that the higher yielding environment we check row width in, the greater the response to narrow on the rows. So row width is going to become more important as we keep moving our yield goals up, not less important.